designing for all means to design, for instance, for elderly, but also for to design products for people who have disability, but also for other users. But the main focus is to get the requirements of people with special needs into the project.
The current project design nowadays does not address the approach designed for all, resulting in modifications that have to be done afterwards. This is often very costly and time-consuming. For example, to adjust a car, it can cost between 15,000 to 30,000 euros.
The products that are already in the market are normally working fine, even if they lack of accessibility from time to time, but they are also not really that user-friendly as they could be.
VERITAS is an integrated project that conducts research in the area of virtual user modeling, targeting people with disabilities and also elderly. The goal is to design new products that are fully accessible by people with disabilities and elderly, taking into account the requirements from the very early phases of development and implementation of new products. We are targeting various application areas in the automotive domain, the smart living spaces domain, the healthcare domain, the infotainment domain, and also the workplace domain. The goal of VERITAS is to create virtual user models that can be used by developers and designers for testing their applications at any time without the need of involving real users, which takes a lot of time and delays the implementation procedure.
Several design solutions are built in hardware prototypes, and then in real test, the accessibility is tested on these hardware prototypes, especially for aspects which cannot be simulated before. And nowadays, also in these prototypes, disabled and elderly people are addressed to do the test on prototypes because at the moment they cannot be simulated before.
The automotive development process is already strongly based on simulation, which has undoubted advantages in timing and coverage of performances. When we cannot simulate, we use a panel of subjects representative of the population. So we expect from VERITAS to extend the simulation coverage of the performance achievement of the vehicle, especially for those innovative applications which per se can guarantee accessibility.
You can imagine that we can design a very nice ADAS system if the human-machine interface is not correctly performed. The system will not be accepted or trusted by the drivers. On the other side, we are addressing all drivers. The final user are all drivers from when you get your driving license up to elderly drivers. And it is well known that elderly drivers have a lot of problems. They have can have some physical problems, some physiological problems. For example, they have some head restriction for the head rotation restriction. They can have some limitation in the field of view. Well, also some problems with the mind, and we definitely think that that VERITAS project will provide us some new tools which will be helpful to design these new ADAS systems in the future.
In a VERITAS project, Piaggio intends to introduce in the ergonomic design process new instruments that will be able to evaluate also limited physical impairments.
When you speak about the development of the applications for the healthcare domain, we may find that there's a lot of use guidelines and recommendations that will provide a great usability and acceptance by the part of the end users. But we can find that there's a lack when we consider the accessibility for people with impairments.
The added value of VERITAS will be the possibility to have an indication about the usability of our solution, our interfaces, before to reach the development of the product. So this is a very, we expect this innovation could have a relevant impact in our costs, the design and development costs of our solution.
We expect from Veritas that we can set up the whole system before we have to install them, because a problem today is that we can only test the complete system when it is installed and when it is used by the end user. And when you want to make changes, then it is quite difficult. Yes, and with Veritas, we expect that we can do everything before we install the system at the end user, and we can test it and simulate it and also involve the end user. And so we can save a lot of time and money before we have the system ready.
Through the Veritas simulation platform, workspace developers will be able to assess their applications during the design process by simply simulating the usage of their prototypes. Such assessment is not only targeted to the accessibility of interactive applications, but also is extended to the workplace itself.
Right now, the design cycle for infotainment applications involves the designer to create first an interface as a mock-up, and then the application, and when the application is completed, to test it against actual users to see if the application is accessible or not to all kinds of users. This is expensive because at the end of the cycle, if you decide that something is not correctly created, then you need to go back in the drawing board and redesign your interface in order to accommodate people with disabilities. With Veritas, we are going to change this cycle so that in the design process, using the Veritas tools, the designer can see if the user interface is accessible or not before actually creating the application.
On the one hand, Veritas is targeting the creation of virtual user models. These virtual user models will represent various people with disabilities and also elderly, and will give the opportunity to the designer to introduce avatars that in 3D design or personas in 2D designs in order to evaluate the interfaces and the designs they have in various application domains, and be able to get feedback on the accessibility of the interface and the corrections that need to be made in order to provide more accessible new products.
The Veritas avatar is the visual representation of a beneficiary of the Veritas project. This means that it is what the end user, the designer, will see in real-time 3D graphics when designing the product for a beneficiary, for a disabled or elder people. We constructed avatars in two ways. The first is programmatically with the software, taking demographical data, statistics about the age, the age, the size, the weight of the people, and automatically building an avatar for the Veritas project. The second way is through the work, the handcraft of 3D artists that used the very same tools that are used in cinema for digital movie production to build the avatars that will be inserted also in the Veritas project.
One of the most important aspects of the Veritas project is to monitor and measure parameters, physical parameters. This can be done in two different ways. One way is to use a separate system of sensors. The other one is to integrate all of them together in one platform. And that's what we have decided in Veritas. The multisensor platform is composed by several systems. Motion tracking, which is used for gait analysis, an electrogoniometer, which is used for the monitoring of the knee movement, a natural platform that can be used to measure the inclination of arms and limbs with the ground, a human glove for the monitoring of the hand, a motion capture that is used for monitoring all parts of the body, the force panel, which is used to measure, to control the skill of the person, the load cell to measure the force of the arms, and video sensing to monitor the movement of the arms in a car usually, And the VICON, which is a standard, a gold standard, very complex for monitoring of the whole body movement.
We developed a garment-based motion capture, which is very, very new in the panorama of the system that captures the motion of users, of people, in the sense that it is able to measure simultaneously the shape of the body and the motion.
We have, as final step, gathered and complete a model with all of these parameters affected by psychological state that represent different behaviors of the VERITAS user models.
On the other hand, VERITAS gives the designer the opportunity to be immersed in a virtual environment and act as the user with disabilities in order for him or her to be able to take the role of the disabled person and understand the actual difficulties that they have when interacting with the environment.
Let's consider this example. A designer wants to test if the interface he has created for one game is visible to people with low visibility or with cataract or with any other impairment concerning their eyes. With VERITAS, they can load that particular user model, let's say a cataract user model, and they can see through the eyes of the impaired user with cataract showing black spots on the screen as they try to look at the interface. If they try to, for example, click on a button which is not visible because of a black spot in the users, the impaired users' visual field, they will have to see the interface from another point of view and see if they can move the object to a position that is more accessible.
The main challenge is to try to represent a real human with a virtual user model. You understand how difficult it is, of course. We cannot support all functionalities a real human would be able to perform in a real environment, but we can support basic functionalities, we can support also some complex tasks a real human would perform in his environment. And the goal is to target the main parts of the interface of each of the applications that we are developing, so that to be sure that this interface is mostly accessible.
These measurements have taken places in many countries in Europe with all ranges of disabilities and older people. Of course, at the final stage, we will also rely on people with disabilities to test those kind of products that have been designed using the VERITAS simulators.
VERITAS planned three user and beneficiary forums, so three moments in which the users, so the designers and the developers, and the beneficiaries, so older people, but also people with disabilities and people with other different kinds of impairments, gathered together and have been able to exchange their views and their needs on the products and services that VERITAS is dealing with.
It's a challenge. People speaking different languages, not in terms of national languages only, but also in terms of their backgrounds that they have. So it's a challenge on the first hand, but on the other hand, it gives us a lot of benefit. So we have all the people in the, all the stakeholders right at hand in the projects, and we can really work very effectively taking into account the needs of the different stakeholders from industry, from research, but also disabled people and elderly people. All are inside the project.